Hello, Internet. Welcome to Merlin's Archery Adventures. Here at Merlin Archery, we've never been busier since the outbreak of the zombie apocalypse. But like all good businesses, we're evolving with the times to take care of our ever-dwindling customer base. Here's how. Our highly trained staff. Hiya, Brian.
Hi.
Are constantly working day and night trying to find you the best way to take on the zombie horde. So why not sign up for one of our zombie slaying seminars, giving you the best possible leg up in the event of a zombie apocalypse. Hello, Internet. This is Howard. Howard will be showing us some of the bows you might be using during a zombie apocalypse. He's also going to be trying out the new vaccine for us. It's also a really powerful muscle relaxant. Oh, look at what Howard's got there. It's a traditional English longbow. A very good place to start, Howard. What are you going to do with that, Howard? Are you going to try and kill some zombies? But before you start, what do you need to do? No, don't get an arrow just yet. You need to warm your bow up first. No, not like that, Howard. You need to give it some pre-draws. Get the wood nice and warm before you start shooting those zombies. Coincidentally, look who just showed up. Better get shooting, Howard. First, let's take a look at the plus sides in shooting the longbow in a zombie apocalypse. It's fun to shoot. You can shoot a large quantity of arrows very quickly. Oh, lovely shooting, Howard. You got him right in the chops with that one. As much as I love the English longbow, there is a downside. Unless you really know what you're doing, it's very difficult to be accurate. Never mind, Howard. Never mind. Hello, Howard. Are you okay? Ooh, Howard's got an American flat bow. Very nice. But what's that on the side? It's a bow quiver. Yes, but it only holds 5 arrows, so you better make them count. Oh, look. Zombies. You're shooting off the shelf on this bow, so you should get a little bit more accuracy. Little bit more consistency out of this one. Oh, a lovely shot, Howard. One down, 4 to go. And that's 2. Lovely. And that's 3. You really are doing very well, Howard. And that makes 4. Splendid. Howard, try and keep that elbow down. Lean back a little bit. In traditional archery, it's important to keep a good, solid form. That's lovely. Oh dear, Howard. It appears you've run out of arrows. I'd probably make a run for it if I was you. But watch out for that. Never mind. Hello, Howard. You starting to get tired and a little bit sore? But don't worry, we've got a survival bow for you. You have to fold the limbs out. That's it, turn those little screws just there. That's it, now fold the limbs out. Lovely. Very good, Howard. No, it's not a spear, Howard. Nor is it a javelin. It's a bow. Here, take this string. Oh, did I not show you how to string a bow? Oh, that's my fault. I'm very sorry, Howard. But just give it a good try anyway. But you better hurry up. Those zombies are getting closer. Oh, never mind, Howard. Never mind. Oh, hello, Howard. Are you okay? Are you not really enjoying yourself? What have you got there? That looks like a target-style recurve. Although, in the right hands, very accurate. It's a bit big, and those stabilizers make it a little bit hard to carry around. Who gave you that? Give it back. Ah, that's much better. Thank you, Brian. That's a field-style recurve. It's a lot shorter and easier to carry around. You'll do really well with that. Just in time. The zombies are here. Behind you. Wow, Howard, you're doing splendidly. Just need to tidy up that release a touch, and you've got the makings of a good archer there. Well, it looks like you got all of those zombies. Very well done, Howard. You did fantastic. That was really impressive. You're the man. But aren't you forgetting something? Oh, hello, Howard. How are you? It looks like you're having a very bad day. But what have you got there? It looks like a target-style compound. It looks very pretty, Howard, but just like the recurve, the target compound probably isn't the best bow to have in the zombie apocalypse, what with that sight and those stabilizers. You better give it back. Ah, that's more like it. That's a field-style compound, or a hunting bow. That's essentially your sniping weapon. Great for taking zombies out at long distances. But you need to use a release aid. And take your time. So you need to make every shot count. Why don't you take a little look through your binoculars? What can you see? Oh, there he is. Have you got him, Howard? Now remember, Howard, take your time. Line up the shot. You have to make this one count. Oh, jolly good, Howard. You got him first try. Well done. Just confirm your kill. Look at that. You should be very pleased with yourself. But be careful of your surroundings. Oh, hello there, Howard. Oh, you poor thing. It's not going very well for you, is it? But don't worry, we've got one last thing for you to try. Some would say it's the ultimate survival weapon. The crossbow. Very powerful and very accurate. Why don't you just try and cock it? Oh dear, Howard, can't you reach? Is it a little bit much for you? Would you like to hand it back and try something a little bit more your size? Splendid, thank you, Brian. Oh, that one should be a little bit more your size, Howard. You'll get on all right with that one. That is the downside to the crossbow, though. It does take a long time to load. Will it give you enough time before the zombies get too close? That's it. Pop the bolt in. That's it, Howard. Get it nice and close into your shoulder. Don't forget to take the safety off. Fantastic! Bullseye! Do you think you'll be able to get one more shot off, Howard? Come on, you can do it! Pull! Oh, Howard, you're really tired, aren't you? You haven't got any energy left. You could always just run away. Well, it would appear that Howard thinks he can do better on his own. But don't worry about him, I'm sure he'll be fine. No, I'm sure he'll be fine. But in the meantime, why not visit one of our zombie survival centres or check us out online for all your zombie apocalypse survival needs. Bye bye, everybody. Bye bye.